anticipation was high for the 10th day of the European Para Championships, marked by a special para-cycling event featuring two qualification rounds and a final race through the city centre. Meanwhile, para-basketball, badminton and shooting events continued to evolve at the Ahoy Centre. The para-cycling competition started with a mixed team relay, completing two qualifying rounds and culminated in an intense final race.
Paracycling Explained. Paracycling, an adapted form of cycling, accommodates various disabilities. Athletes compete in individual time trials, team relays, or road races, and are categorized into 13 classes: male or female athletes with various impairments, or balance impairments, hand bike riders, or visually impaired tandem riders with a non-impaired partner. Despite different classes racing together, results are adjusted based on mobility level, ensuring fairness and excitement. Adjustments include unique rules and staggered start times for the time trials.
Switzerland start with the usual tactic of trying to get in front, but it's France out of the start with the best line, followed by Switzerland, Italy, and Germany and the Netherlands just behind that. On the back straight, so to speak, we have this left-hander, 180 degrees, Italy one and France neck to neck, followed by Andrea Eskau in third position for Germany. Diego Colombari first, followed by Joseph Rich from France. Andrea Eskau. And here we have Tiziano Monti from Italy too. France and Italy one, it looks like, are going to fight for the win. But as we saw in the qualification heats, anything can happen in these short explosive laps. Here we have Johan Kyle through the 180-degree corner, first with a few seconds up to Italy 1, Germany and Italy 2, almost at the same Italy 2 in the slipstream there, with the Netherlands in 5th place and Switzerland in 6th place. And it looks like Mastroni is managing that reasonably well. There is a gap, but it's not grown very much. Meanwhile, Vico Magline has taken the lead in this fight for third place against Davide Cortini. Also now here pulling away from Porcellato. Interesting to see on the second of their laps, it looked like Porcellato was stronger than Vincent, but now it seems like Vincent kept something back. No problems there, and he can accelerate again, knowing that he will win gold for France once more. Two gold medals for France in the handbike team relay within 5 days. The crowd applauding the French. He lifts his hand and France wins the gold medal. Italy won. Diego Colombari takes silver. And behind we can see Italy 2 giving their last, but Andrea Eskau is too far back. Germany will take the bronze medal. There's bronze for Germany and the 4th place for Italy 2.
The para-cycling competition will resume tomorrow with individual time trials and is set to run until the final day of the event at the Vestergaard. At the Ahoy Centre, in the realm of wheelchair basketball, Four games took place, with the main spotlight on two gripping semi-finals.
Wheelchair Basketball Explained. As the name implies, wheelchair basketball is an adaptation of the unimpaired version. The dimensions of the court and the basket height are the same as those of the unimpaired version, as are the playing time, the number of players on the court, and the scoring structure. However, the number of players on the court is limited by a number of points. Players receive 1 to 4.5 points depending on their level of impairment. In total, there may be a maximum of 14 points on the field at all times.
The first semi-final showcased Great Britain and Germany.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be. Welcome to the semi-finals. Let's get this party started.
I miss Jeff Taylor.
Well, Pratt's best game was against the United States in the group stage, in which he had over 30 points. Now Bubba goes to downtown again. He must get his confidence going early on. Bywater here in the backcourt. Has Pratt to his left. Trying to go to a pick and roll here with Fox. Pratt's been on fire so far, and again, he's not cooling down anytime soon. Germany's defense, very congested. At the moment, needs to be a little bit more aggressive as Bywater's up. Hillsborough, mid-range machine. Up the borough, as they would say, back in the Northeast. The lineup shows the depth and quality of all the players of both Great Britain and Germany. Lewski left wide open. He's got to make this one. Three is up. Three is good. Eins, zwei, Dreifischen, as they would say back in Germany. Pratt with 12 points. Hasn't shot the ball since the first quarter. Now he's going to go for another one.
Oh.
Excellence is a continuation demonstrated by Philip Pratt.
1.3 seconds on the shot clock.
They'll simply get it, put it up. Gooden's got to shoot this one. Shot is up. And oh. Well, Gooden right at the dying moments. Tenure on the shot clock. Pratt's taking one three. He's missed it already, but takes another one. Well, you call him the facilitator. I might call him the British Terminator for that matter.
Oh, yeah. 19 points now for Pratt.
Germany, they still have a room, but they'll have to do it in April 2024 because at the end of this game, Great Britain wins 63-42 in a very emphatic defeat of Germany. Congratulations to British wheelchair basketball.
Goes to show how unbelievably deep we are. We have so many players who can play so many different roles. Lee Manning dropped 30 points yesterday, and then today was just protecting me and Greg Warburton to give me open shots. Like, obviously, if I can create for the others, then great. But if Lee Manning's working like that and getting myself open, it'd be rude for me to not shoot those shots. So, shout out to Lee. Shout out to Greg for finding me every time. Shout out to all my teammates who are just creating easy looks for myself. I mean, I knew they'd come out with some adjustments, but then we were also planning for it. We planned for it as well. We had kind of had like one or two steps ahead of what they were doing. We knew the adjustment would come. We did a great job on stopping Alex Haluski. That guy, oh my God, he can shoot the ball. You're just terrified every time he comes to the half court. He's going to pull up from wherever, and Thomas Bomer as well. So we did a really good job on switching onto them and giving up shots to their weaker shooters, if you like. But yeah, no, shout out to our guys. Simon Brown, Harry Brown coming on and just being absolute defensive menaces and changing the game for us. It's awesome having the women's team back in the final as well, obviously. We train at the same place as them as well out in Loughborough, so it's I play with Charlotte Moore, my club team as well, so it's awesome to have them in the final, and hopefully we can both get it done tomorrow.
In the second semi-final, the Netherlands competed against Spain, a team they'd previously overcome in the tournament with a 6-point lead.
Well, when the tip gets going, business will start to pick up. Let's get this party underway. Spain getting the first possession, Nacho Ortega. Kicking this one out to Robin Pogovich. He'll go for the deep one. Shot is up. It counted. Getting the first 3-point field goal. And Nightwing feeling the confidence early on. Netherlands with a chance to retake the lead. They've led by as many as 5 points. Dinner trying to find a bit of time and space on the bank of Rotterdam. Well, deposit your chest because Superman is flying into the building. Ortega wide open, puts up the three and picks. Puntos. Por favor. Nacho, it's now Fuego at the moment. As you mentioned, more players need to get the lineup. Now Nacho has to force a prayer up. End of the shot clock. Are you kidding me? Ay, Dios mío. Wow. Well, KO to S. Right now, it is nacho time. Garcia down the middle. Trying to look for options. Crosscourt finding Jordi Ruiz. Puts up the mid-range, and again, it is cooking. But you might need to pull the fire department because Spain, they are on fire here at the moment. Finding Matias Bellas, still scoreless here. Dumps down to Mendel, up there, and another round one, counted. Superman, all of a sudden, carrying the Netherlands on his back, along with the Dutch Nightwing, Robin Hagenbisch. Potential 2-for-1 here for Spain. Garcia's going to go for the three-pointer. Puts it up, and again, buenas noches, España. Garcia putting everybody to bed with that tray ball. Robin finds Mendel. Mendel for the mid-range, and again, six it. He is unconscious. 20 points for Mendel up in it. 5 points is the difference. Spain one again to that dweller in the paint. Garcia finds Jordi Ruiz. He can make these. And again, having huge confidence.
Ruiz, very much a microwave scorer.
Mendel going around the paint. Finding Bellas. Bellas has got to make this one off the backboard. And Matisse Bellas. Big time shot by a big time player. The Netherlands need a big possession right now. Santinger on the baseline goes up, and a big time play cutting it back down to a 6 point ball game. Almost throwing it away. Santinger got to make this big three. Oh, baby! Cutting it back down to a 5 point ball game. Santinger, he is unconscious. Well, Spain, it's been a roller coaster for them. Losses to Germany, losses to the Netherlands. But Spain have officially qualified for the Paris 2024 Paralympics. La Familia, Vamos España, they're on their way to Paris. Felicidades, congratulations.
The wheelchair basketball competition will carry on tomorrow with crucial women's matches, while the men's final is scheduled for Saturday. A remarkable match took place in para badminton, involving multiple European champion Ilke Tulsku, who faced Jack Wilson.
Para badminton explained. Para badminton, adapted for athletes with physical disabilities, permits aids like prosthetics and wheelchairs. Athletes are divided into six classes: wheelchair users with impairments in lower limbs and or trunk function, standing athletes with impairments in lower or upper limbs or imbalance and coordination, and athletes with small stature and reduced reach. They compete in singles, as well as men's, women's, and mixed doubles.
Not getting any younger. Oh, brilliant from Jack Wilson.
Well done, Jack. Put a little bit Ilke under pressure there.
Yeah, Ilke's only played two tournaments since the World Championships last year.
That's a brilliant cross net from Jack there, cross block.
Good defense. See, you can see that's coming. He wasn't going to hit hard then. It's short. Oh, I thought Jack would have gone for it instead. The slice, drop shot, brilliant choice.
Lovely slow slice there. Great. Really took the pace out of it.
Nice cross net. Brilliant from Jack Wilson.
Was that in?
It was, on
wow.
The line.
Wow.
For me, Jack really needs this second game, you know. Ilke's been here so many times over so many years. Loads of three games, matches, big important finals. If this goes to three, I think he'll be the steadier mentally. I don't think he can keep up with Jack physically.
Good play by Ilka there.
Yeah, well reached. That is superb from Jack Wilson.
That's great quality badminton, that is. Good pickup.
What's Jack got left?
Good defence.
Ilka staying patient.
Oh.
Jack's gone wildly wide.
Yeah, it's good play by Ilka.
Ilka's just a bit steadier mentally. It's not over yet. It is now. Superb from the Turk. Ilka Tuzcu does it again. He's battled through the years in situations like this, and so often he comes out on top.
Amir Levy, the silver medalist from the last European Championships, carried his momentum forward in a thrilling encounter against Mark Elmer.
Oh, that's nice from Elmer. Flat and devastating.
That was really good play. That was so awkward for Amir to get behind the shot and get anything decent.
Better. Good defence. And again, he's over the top and it's in.
That's a fantastic shot by Mark. Really impressive.
Nice remark. Couldn't find. Ah, there he is. Found a way through.
He has finally. Couple drops, all sorts. Just get your opponent thinking. That's a nice shot from Elmer. Nice and flat lift over Amir's head.
Up short. Oh, what a shot. I was expecting the power smash. Rick Hellman, by the way, already through the number one seed. It's just served out. I thought that was ace.
No, served out. It's clearly short.
Difficult to see from here. Relief, I think, on the face of Amir. Because that was a strange opening game.
He made hard work of it, the first set.
Yeah.
Played well. Got a bit of momentum, put a bit of grit, a bit of determination, a bit of fire in his belly. And come through really well.
The para shooting sport witnessed its inaugural medal competition, featuring two finals in the 10-metre rifle standing category.
Shooting para sport explained. Shooting parasport is for athletes with physical and visual disabilities, using air guns to target 10 rings scored to one decimal place. Disciplines vary by air gun type, pistol or rifle. Stance, standing, kneeling or prone. And shooting distance. Athletes are classified into three groups based on their disability level. Freehand shooting. Shooting with air gun support or an assistant, and visually impaired athletes who shoot at a 10-meter range using sound signals for aiming, with the highest tone indicating a maximum score of 10.9.
And then we'll move into our single shot phase, where we'll have our first elimination after shot 12. Now, there was a shoot-off in the last final. Who knows, we might even get another one in this R1 men's 10-metre air rifle standing SH1 competition. If you are just joining us, then welcome. The shot clock is up and running, and the shots are coming in. A 10.7 from Dodoshenko, that doesn't surprise me one little bit. Likewise, Dobrowolski of Poland with a 10.7, follows that with a 10.9. here is Goroshenko. Would certainly be my tip in this final for a medal. Gold medalist at the World Cup in Munich. So after the first series of five shots, this is how it tops the table. 51.6 for Doroshenko of Ukraine. I'm expecting him to go very well in this final. 0.5 in front of Johansson of Denmark. So Gustafsson of Sweden, who was further down towards the scoreboard just at the beginning of this final, has managed to move up to fourth even for Gustafsson. And then it's Winter of Denmark, who's just to the right of your screen there, who's shooting to stay in this. Only 0.1 difference, though. Very, very close. 9.4.
I suspect that's not enough.
So Jan Winter's going to need a pretty disastrous shot here. A 10.5, nice and solid, and stays in. So Håkan Gufvesten of Sweden will be leaving this final in fifth place. So it's between these two, Denmark versus Poland. Who will take bronze?
Start.
And who will go on to fight for silver and gold? And you see the different grips as well there on the rifle.
Different position, yes.
And that's what makes this such a technical and individual sport as well. Dobrovolski opting for the visor. Meanwhile, Martin Black Johansson of Denmark, shake of the head. No visor for him, but it's just not enough. So Denmark at least have a medal. And although there's a shake of the head as well from Martin, I think at the end of the day, I think when he looks back on this, he'll be pleased to take a bronze.
For the next competition shot, load.
Dobrovolski 2.7 behind. That's a massive margin to make up over what could be the final two shots unless we go to a shoot-off. But is Doroshenko, as he takes his aim, staring down towards another gold medal. He took a gold medal at the Munich World Cup last summer.
You see if the shoulders are always the same way, that means you have a lot of experience. Stop.
So Marek with a 10.3, Andre with a 10.2. So it closes the gap to 2.4. Sorry, makes it now 2.6. So Doroshenko gets that shoulder going, locks himself in. The cheek already right on the cheek plate. Meanwhile, Dobrovolski just taking his time just a little bit. 40 seconds left on the clock. Dobrovolski will probably fire first and does so just. With a 10.3 and a 10.3 also from Doroshenko, it means Ukraine indeed do have a gold medal. It's their first medal of the shooting calendar at this European Para Championships. And once again, Andrei Doroshenko now starts to smile and waves over to the crowd. Absolutely delighted with his performance. He just led all the way. Such a dominant, dominant show from this man.
Tomorrow, parachuting sport will hold two finals in the 10-metre air rifle standing and 10-metre air rifle prone SH1 categories. After 10 days in Rotterdam, the Netherlands continue to hold the top spot in the overall standings, even though the hosts weren't able to secure medals on this particular day. France and Ukraine added two gold medals each to their tally, while Gorazd Franček Tiršek's gold medal marked the first for Slovenia. Tomorrow, all eyes will be on the Ahoy Hall, where the badminton playoffs start with quarter-final matches. Parachuting sport will host two finals, and the highlight will be the women's basketball final showdown between the Netherlands and Great Britain.
Welcomed with open arms, and as a result, the action has been so exciting, so thrilling. It's been so much fun to watch.
Hello and welcome. It's day one of the parachuting competition.
He's crafty, he's very clever, he plays all the right shots at the right time.
That is a big time play by a big time player.
There is a start of the same team.